here.
Chill, Sam. Damn, all right? Let the man in.
Got this.
Got this. Look, who are you to throw me out?
Oh. Well, I think I'm head of this house. And I'm doing things my way.
If I were to read a description of your characters out loud, I think certain people would think I was talking about three or four different people. They're like pretty complex.
Yeah,
when you were like
so
putting your character together, for lack of a better term, mm-hmm. were you thinking of multiple people in your own life, perhaps?
I didn't think of multiple people. I think as humans, we're all very layered. If you just think of yourself, and for me, thinking of myself, I have a lot of things that go on with me. Maybe today I feel like these three things, and tomorrow I'm made of these seven things. But they're all still me, and they don't necessarily conflict. And they can make up a whole person.
Yeah, I think that that's true. I definitely had, some reference points that were really outside of myself that were like, you know, as varied as, I don't know, like Angela Davis or Aubrey Plaza or like, or B. Arthur or, I mean, they were kind of all over the place. Or like David Bowie. I mean, I had like a lot of ideas. So sometimes I'd like try to calibrate like how Angela Davis is Sam White in this particular moment. But I think you're right. Like you're always trying to find, or ideally, you're trying to find the things about yourself that you can accentuate or diminish a bit to try to figure out how to live in that person's shoes. And we're fluid. We have so many parts of us.
I could sit here and listen to you name people like that all day. That was so shocking. I think one thing I like about this movie is that every character has a pretty satisfying moment, you know, like where we
yeah.
see like the a new side of them, etc.
Yeah.
What do you think was the most satisfying moment for both of your characters, or your most satisfying moment in the movie?
I wouldn't necessarily say satisfied, but the moment at that party where you see Coco take in everything that's around her and really I think so much goes through her head where the things Sam White has said start to come in her head, and she starts feeling these emotions that she didn't necessarily think were there and actually thought were quite ridiculous for people like Sam White to talk about and stand on their soapbox and make everybody else think about it. In that moment when you see her have to contend with the images that are in front of her, and how will she go forward from here? Does she continue to assimilate and move forward as she has been? Does she kind of embrace some of the things that the Beaufros have spoken about for so long? That moment, not knowing which way or how she'll move forward in life, but seeing her actually be affected by the images in front of her, that was a satisfying moment for me as an actress.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily know if Coco thought that was satisfying.
I think mine is probably similar. I think you, like, particularly for these two characters that are so interested in their outward persona, I think it's satisfying for the actor, but also for the audience to see a crack in the veneer. And that happens in a moment with Sam White, too, and that was satisfying for me.
And similarly, do you have a most difficult moment with your character, like coping with, how do I get this part when I'm also this character has this other personality that seems like it would conflict maybe at first, you know?
I did with the moment that I think you kind of see Sam White vulnerable, because the question was, how does someone who's not accustomed to ever being vulnerable, how are they when they're vulnerable? It's a different kind of vulnerability than anybody else. I think someone like Sam White, as soon as there's a little crack, she has to like plaster it up very quickly. So that was challenging, trying to figure out that.
The most challenging part for me was going into that the party scene, having to put the makeup on. It was maybe four shades lighter, and then the blue contacts, and then the blonde hair. I had a moment myself of just, it made me sick, really, because I realized that there are women who feel like this is the only way to be beautiful, and that's the way that they have to navigate the world in order to have be paid attention to. And so for me, it was really difficult going into that scene having to look like that.
For the latest from HitFix, visit HitFix.com or download the new HitFix app on your Roku device.